Today we will learn chapter 2, direction, scale and maps. We have already learned in our previous class about directions and maps. There are four main directions: north, south, east and west. Let's make your direction arrow. For this you have to take a thick book cover or any card. On it, sketch direction arrows with pen. Then carefully cut the arrows. Your direction arrow is ready now. This is a map. Look for the narrow path which goes along the western edge of Chandanpur to Badgaon. With the help of arrows, mark the river which flows along Pipalia, touches Badgaon and then passes through Chandpur and Chandanpur. Then draw a jungle between Pipalia and Chandpur. After that, draw a narrow path from Chandpur to Badgaon in a way that primary school lies on its way. After that, show a hospital in the north of Chandanpur. Sketches and maps. Sketches are an imitation of the real objects. The map is always drawn showing aerial view. Different signs and symbols are used to show various things on a map. While drawing a map, north direction is shown upward, south direction is shown downward, east direction is on right side and west direction is shown in left side. Measurement scales are used to represent direction and distance in a map. Geeta drew a sketch of her school. While sketching, she took into consideration the length of each room. She collected matchsticks. She measured class 1, class 2 and headmaster's room with her footsteps. Each matchstick indicated a footstep which was taken to measure the length of the wall. She arranged matchsticks to indicate the length of other wall. Carefully see the sketch and the matchsticks. On the basis of the sketch, tell the following. Class 1 is 6 footsteps in length and 4 footsteps in width. Class 2 is 6 footsteps in length and 5 footsteps in width. Headmaster's room is 9 footsteps in length and 4 footsteps in width. We get these footsteps by counting the number of matchsticks taken by Geeta to measure the length of the wall.